Welcome back to my channel Electronic Science Tutorial. Today is the 14th class of Operational Amplifier. Today I will discuss the logarithmic amplifier by using an op-amp. So without any time waste, let's start our class. Logarithmic amplifier by using an op-amp. This is the basic circuit of logarithmic amplifier by using an op-amp. So this is the op-amp, this is the non-inverting terminal, and this is the non-inverting terminal. Non-inverting terminal is connected with the ground connection, and the inverting terminal is connected with a input resistance R1. V1 is applied, V1 is the supply voltage which is applied to the inverting terminal through input resistance R1, and one diode is connected in the feedback path. That means at the output and the input of the inverting terminal, one diode is connected. So this is the basic logarithmic amplifier circuit by using an op-amp. Okay, so here I use one supply voltage, that is V1, one input resistor, that is R1, and one diode in the feedback path. Non-inverting terminal is connected with the ground connection. Now, what is logarithmic amplifier? Log amplifier is an electronic circuit that produces an output that is proportional to the logarithm of the applied input. Right? So, when we apply the KCL at the point G, that means Kirchhoff's current law at the point of G, what we have to write? The current at the point G when we apply KCL, that is I1 equal to I2, the entering current and the leaving current from this node is equal. That means the entering current is I1 and the leaving current from this node, means from the G node. So this current is IF, this is the feedback current, this current is leaving from this node, and I1 current, which is generated by the V1 supply voltage, this is the entering current into this node. So I1 equal to IF we have to write. Now the input current, what is the value of input current? I1, that is V1 by R1. I1 equal to V1 by R1. V1 is the input supply voltage and R1 is the input resistor. That means now how we calculate the feedback current? The feedback current in the feedback path, we connect one diode. So when we consider the feedback current, we have to consider the diode current, right? We connect one diode into the feedback path, into the output terminal to the inverting terminal, one diode has to be connected. So in the feedback path, that means in this path, which current will flow? Diode current will flow. So what current we consider? Diode current we consider. That means the feedback current is the diode current. So diode current is, we have to consider here. Now, what is the IF value? If we put I1 equal to V1 by R1, then IF equal to V1 by R1. Now, what is the value of IF? That means diode current. The diode current is IF equal to ID, that is equal to, ID means diode current, IF means feedback current, that is equal to IS e to the power VF divided by VT eta. IS is the reverse saturation current of the diode, PN diode. VF is the applied forward voltage of the diode. VT is the thermal voltage, and eta is the which kind of semiconductor is used to make this diode. That means if this diode is silicon diode or this diode is germanium diode. Okay, on that value, the eta value is dependent. So the diode current is IF equal to ID equal to IS e to the power VF divided by VT eta. Now, if we apply the KVL equation in the feedback loop, that means in this loop, KVL equation where we apply, where we saw a closed circuit, there we apply a KVL equation of Kirchhoff's voltage law equation. And Kirchhoff's voltage law, what is the Kirchhoff's voltage law? The each and every point voltage drop is equal to the zero of this loop, of this closed loop. So in this feedback loop, which voltages are here? One is diode voltage, one is the output voltage. So can we write the KVL equation applied around the feedback loop of the op-amp will be VF plus V0 equal to 0. This is the diode voltage plus this is the output voltage, that is equal to 0. So total voltage around this closed loop, this closed feedback loop is 0. This is the diode voltage VF and this is the output voltage. So VF plus V0 equal to 0. Now what do we write? Substitute the value of VF in the diode current, what we get, that is IF equal to VF equal to the, from this equation what we get, that VF equal to minus V0. So VF equal to minus V0, if we substitute this value in this diode current, what we get, we obtained IS e to the power minus V0 divided by eta VT. So this is the diode current. Now now from this equation, if we write IF equal to V1 by R1 in the left hand side, if we put this value, that is V1 by R1 equal to IS e to the power minus V0 divided by eta VT. Now from this equation we can write, that is V1 by R1 IS equal to e to the power minus V0 divided by eta VT. Then if we write this equation, we can write it as ln V1 divided by R1 IS equal to minus V0 eta VT. That means what is the value of V0? V0 equal to eta VT ln V1 by R1 IS. That means we get the log amplifier or the logarithm of the applied input signal voltage. Logarithm of the applied input signal voltage, that means V1. So this is the logarithmic amplifier. And why we get minus here? Because the supply voltage is applied at the inverting terminal. So here we get minus here. Eta is the value of silicon diode or germanium diode. Eta is dependent on the on this property, material property, that is this diode, either this diode is germanium diode or silicon diode. Vt is the thermal voltage, ln V1 divided by R1 IS. IS is the reverse saturation current, R1 is the input resistor. So first of all, we have to calculate the KCL at the point G. That means I1 equal to IF. From this point, we have to calculate first, that is the input current. The value of input current is V1 by R1. If we put this input current value, then what is the feedback current value? That is V1 by R1 equal to IF. Then we have to calculate the feedback current. Feedback current means in the feedback loop, we have considered one diode. So when we consider feedback current, we have to consider the diode current. That means the diode current is the feedback current. That is IF equal to ID. That is equal to IS e to the power VF divided by eta VT. Now, one KVL equation applied, KVL law applied into the feedback path, where the two voltage we saw in this loop, in this closed loop, that is one is diode voltage and the another one is output voltage. VF plus V0 equal to 0 according to the KVL law. Then if we substitute this V0 value into the diode current equation, then we get the output voltage. And this output voltage is the proportional to the logarithm of the applied input. Okay. So this is the logarithmic amplifier circuit by using an op amp. Okay. Thank you. If you like, do like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.